Now, to dry brush the dirt on the tiles, we need a lighter version of the dirt color, which means we're going to have to add white to the dirt color to make a lighter version of it. Because these different kinds of white are different thicknesses, we're going to have different amounts of white added to the dirt to make the lighter color. For the cheap craft paint, if you're going to add it, I'm going to add 3 parts of white paint to 1 part of the dirt color. For house paint, I'm going to add 2.5 parts of white paint to the dirt color to make the light. And if you're using the Acrylic Artist tube paint, I'm only going to add 2 parts of white to this dirt color to get the right color that we need. So in this case, let's say for some reason I use this. Once again, this is 2 parts of white to the dirt color. Just simply take the dirt color that you've mixed up. And notice I'm only doing a teaspoon of this and a teaspoon of the other. Now, for the dry brushing, you really don't need much paint at all. I would suggest only mixing up a teaspoon worth of it. Okay, there's 1 teaspoon of the white, and then we'll go with another teaspoon of the white. And that should be just about the right amount of white to lighten this up to what we need. And I'm just going to, I'm not really going to thin this. The dry brushing paint can be a little bit thicker, and I don't think you really would have to thin this with anything in order to get it to work. So we're going to mix that up, and then we're going to compare the colors after we get done. Now here's a comparison of the highlight colors from each. Once again, on this one we added 3 parts of white to 1 part dirt. This one we added 2.5 parts of white to 1 part dirt. And this one we added 2 parts white to 1 part dirt. And you can see that these are pretty much spot on the same colors. So just kind of keep that in mind when you're adding white, what kind of white you're adding to it. And this amount that we mixed up is probably plenty of dry brushing paint for the whole dungeon set that we're going to do. I wouldn't mix up any more than that. So what I'm doing is I'm taking our lighter color here, and I am getting it. What you want to do is get some in the brush, and then you want to keep hitting that brush. You want this to be where there's almost nothing in the brush. And it's really handy to do the floor separately like this, because if we had walls sticking up and everything, it would be very difficult to do a nice dry brushing on the floor, because you'd be jamming the brush and hitting the floor a bit too much. So what you want to do is you want to very lightly, and you know, if you have test pieces, of course, do test pieces, a few of them, because we're going to be testing a wash over top of this. So what you want to do is lightly, very lightly go back and forth over it. And if you lightly go back and forth over it and you don't see anything happening, then you're good. You know, you've got it just about the right amount. Now, I just saw a streak right there. See that streak? It means I've got just a little bit, probably a little bit much paint in there. You shouldn't see any streaks. So I'm just going to very lightly go over this. And take your time. Lots of brush strokes, very little pressure, okay? And I'm just going to keep doing this. And there's not very many, you know, floor tile sections, so this is going to be a lot simpler and easier than we did for the brick floor. Now that I'm starting to see a texture, I'm just really lightly hitting over it. Okay, you see the texture coming out? Okay, I'm going to hit it a little bit more. And I want to lighten up this piece quite a bit, because it's going to darken up with the ink wash that we put over it. And it's not a super dark ink wash or anything, but it is going to make a difference on there. So what I'm going to do, I think I've got it just about right. I can see most of the details on there. And so that's what I've got for my detail on there. And with the lamp shining on it, it probably looks a little lighter than it is. But what I would do is I would take this sucker, I would set it right there, and then as you paint additional pieces, you can see when you reach this point right here, you'll know when to stop dry brushing. Because I can lightly go over this, and I can push a little bit more, and then I can kind of change the angle of this, and I'm pushing down. Now you see that texture is starting to come out down here just a little bit. And I'm going to keep going over it and keep going over it. And when it feels like that, you know, it's probably about time to put more paint on the brush. What you can do is you can just pick up paint from the paper towel. Just go over the paper towel a little bit and then start out very lightly, because you picked up more paint than you realized by just grabbing it off the paper towel that way. So I am going to continue this. It's like, well, we're not quite there yet. I still need a little bit more to match what I've got. So I'm going to get a little bit more paint here, a little more on the paper towel, and we are going to keep doing this until we get all of the pieces done. Oh, and by the way, when you're dry brushing it, don't forget to, you are also going to have to dry brush the sides as well. I didn't mean to sweep that, but be sure that you get all of the sides of it. And it's not really important about the sides, but it will look a bit funny if you don't do any dry brushing on the sides of the pieces.